Heyo everyone, Misha B. Barkin here. Welcome back to episode 2 of Fursonas in Depth. Today we're going to look at a fairly uncommon Sona. I think I've met maybe 2 of them ever? Anyway, you've already read the title. Today's Sona is the sheep. While sheep Sonas aren't very common, the animal itself has over 1 billion in the world, with most of them living in China. Secondly, sheep can see about 300 degrees around their head. This allows them to be able to see behind themselves without turning their heads, so they can watch for prey. This would be real useful for us when someone taps the opposite shoulder, then acts like the funniest guy in the room when you look the wrong way and they're like, ha, got you. Anyway, lastly, female sheeps are known as iwis, and male sheeps are rams. And now to talk about our guest, Rye. Rye Baker is another friend of mine, just like Dizzy was. We met at Spokanthro 2019 and, to be honest, hit it off almost immediately. Technically, we met at a furry barbecue about a month earlier, but I didn't really count that because I was extremely awkward. They kept trying to talk to me and I wouldn't reply within very many words and it was in a Wendy's when like 30 of us went because we didn't get invited to the ice cream social because we weren't fucking cool enough, I don't know. We sat together with some other furries and all hit it off pretty well. Rye's been one of my closest friends since then. Anyways, on to the questions. What is your name and Sona?
Hi, my name is Rylan and my fursona is a Shetland sheep.
How involved are you in the furry community?
I'd say I'm somewhat involved into the community, especially with this whole COVID thing. It hasn't been, I guess, a whole thing, but I try my best. I do like a lot of the people around. So yeah, it's something, I guess, huh?
How did this Sona come to be?
This Sona came to be from, well, pretty much just, I guess, experimenting. And I chose this fursona because going through with all the normal stuff, I guess, when it comes to like wolves and foxes, and then you have huskies and dogs, and I don't know, none of them really fit well with me. And I don't know, I guess just having this one, just it really hit different, I guess, if that makes any sense. But yeah, that's why I chose this one.
Why do you think others would choose the sheep as their Sona?
Oh, I think people would choose a sheep as their fursona because, yeah, they're very interesting. Like, a few facts is sheep can look in a 300 degree radius, not quite 360, but can pretty much see behind them just by looking straight. Pretty cool, I think. But, that's what I think.
If you could choose a different species to be your primary fursona, what would it be and why?
If I had to choose a different Sona, I'd have to go with some type of bear, just because, yeah, I guess I'm kind of a bigger guy. And plus, bears are cool. They were like my second choice, honestly. I was a polar bear for a while, which fit for a little bit, until, I don't know if I got bored or what, but it didn't feel right anymore.
Is your Sona a reflection of you, or do they have a separate personality?
So my fursona is 100% a reflection of me, which means that they're kind of based off of me, they kind of look like me, their personality is me, all that kind of stuff. If I wanted to have like another fursona that's not like my main one, it would just be an OC, then I would just, you know, make another one.
Is your Sona species popular or not within the community? Why do you think that is?
Weirdly enough, no. My fursona is not very popular. I mean, I see goats and rams and all that, but sheep in particular, no, they're not. And I really don't know why that is. They're really interesting and quite known, but it's just one of those things that people don't want to be quote-unquote sheep. So kind of dumb, but yeah.
Does your Sona have any special gimmicks or quirks that make them unique?
I'd say a gimmick with my fursona would be he likes purple, and he always has a shirt with bitch on it. At least I try to get it in there, but sometimes I forget. But that's his, I guess, quote-unquote gimmick.
Any last things you'd like to mention?
So other than that, I really don't have any other thing to say, but thank you for having me on the show. I guess you can call this a show, huh? And, Bye-bye.
All right, thanks, Rai. A link to Rai's Twitter will be in the description below. Well, here we are at the end of another video. This is still a fairly new series, so if there's anything you'd like to see more of, or anything you'd like me to ask in the future, be sure to comment it below. Also, let me know if there's any species you would like me to prioritize in the future. Anyways, like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!